Friends, Brian back here with another COSPA update. Welcome to the fastest layer one blockchain in the world. Okay, we're gonna look at this chart in a second. I want to show you guys COSPA changed its home page. COSPA is the fastest open source, decentralized, and fully scalable layer one in the world. There it is. The world's first block DAG, a digital ledger enabling parallel blocks and instant transaction confirmation, built on robust proof of work engine with rapid single second block intervals. There it is. They changed that today. That is now their homepage, the fastest layer one in the world. Okay, so if we go over here, it says this article here says Solana price shows promising signs, but can COSPA overtake Solana with a 30% rise? All right, we're going to go down through here. COSPA poised for a potential 30% rise. The winds of change are constantly blowing. And the latest gust brings us the promising landscape of COSPA. A recent analysis on TradingView suggests a potential 30% rise for COSPA against USDT, with the price expected to reach around 0.031 or 0.032 in the coming weeks. The bullish forecast is backed by the news of COSPA's testnet operating at 10 BPS, a significant development that could potentially position COSPA as the fastest layer one in the world. This would put it ahead of Cardano, Ripple, or Solana, a coin we analyzed in the first part of the article. The technical indicators and chart patterns align with this optimistic outlook, further strengthening the case for a potential surge in value. However, as with any investment, it's essential to approach this with a balanced perspective, considering both the potential rewards and risks. It says COSPA's potential rise is a testament to the dynamic nature of this market. It's a reminder that innovation and technological advancements can significantly impact a crypto's position and value. So congratulations, everybody. If you've seen this ahead of time, and if you're watching this video, you did. Congratulations. Yeah, this is no longer going to be a secret, okay? This is going to get out pretty quick. Largest or the fastest layer one in the world. That's huge. You're going to see the people piling in, I'm sure. Okay, this is the bubbles on the weekly here. You can see some big, huge gainers out there. Okay, here's the daily. Some nice, there's cost down here, 6.2. Not everything corrected the whole way down, that's for sure. Was expecting a little bit deeper corrections in the market, but didn't get them. So we go back over here to these charts. All right, I'm going to show you guys something here in a second. First off, we're just going to take a real fast look through here. Going to try to keep this pretty short today. All right, I was tracking Bitcoin dominance earlier, broke out of that resistance area right there. Okay, but it is showing weakness here. Okay, it's obviously it's rolling over here on the 4 hour. You can see down here on the RSI at 4 hour wants to roll over on this thing. Look, did you see? If you've seen that, it's look at it flicking up and down. Watch it here a second. Let's see it going up and down. You can see how that works with this thing. If it starts coming down hard, it'll correct hard. But right now it's bullish on the 4 hour. Okay, the eight. Is turning bearish. It's still bullish, but just barely. It wants to go bearish. The 12 hour is at the bottom. It's bullish right now, but the daily coming down. Kind of a mixed bag there. All right, so we'll keep an eye on this thing. Obviously, we're looking for it to break down. That's what we want to see here. So hopefully we get the breakdown here. We'll have to keep an eye on this Bitcoin dominance. But right now it's a 51.74. Bitcoin's looking great, up $417. I've been tracking this thing since this morning. If you put a Fibonacci on here, we came up and hit that 786 twice here. Okay, once before I drew this trend line and then once after. All right, I'm tracking this. If you see this X here, you know, if we take this off here, I'm tracking it to so if it breaks this trend line, I know this thing's going to come down further. Okay, now it has obviously two trend lines here. Now it has an upper one here and a lower one, so I'll be keeping an eye on this. If you go out on the hourly, you can see how you can track these things up. A lot of people, when they short the market, they'll track it the whole way up, and as soon as it breaks that trend line, you know, they'll go short on the coin, and that's where Well, not financial advice. I don't do that. I'm not a financial advisor, but that's how a lot of people short the market. They track it like that with the trend line. Okay, so Bitcoin's looking pretty decent. Dow Jones is up 217 points. The DXY still rolling over a little bit here. We go on to 4 hour. Okay, you can see the 4 hour RSI is at the bottom, but it's just neutral. It's at a 528 and a 528. The 8 is bearish, the 12 bearish. All right, and the daily flipped back bullish at a 44, but we have that bearish divergence down there too that we're keeping an eye on with this thing. So we're also tracking that with the trend line here. Okay, so take a quick look at the total one and the total two, and then we're going to get the KOSPA here. I'm going to keep this fairly short today. We have a bull flag. We had that bull flag forming up here on the total market cap. That's on the daily. If we go on the hourly, you can see we're just outside of that, okay? Just outside of that wedge, all right? So you can see the hourly wants to turn down here on the RSI. The 4 hour is coming up, and the 8 hour just turned up. But of course, that weekly, that's the one that we're keeping an eye on. That's the big one there, okay? Here's the total market cap without Bitcoin. Let's zoom in here on the hourly. All right, you can see we're still just playing around right outside of that wedge. So we still have a breakout going with this thing. We're just on the outside of that wedge still. We're up to $555.6 billion waiting for this thing to really start tearing, and it's gonna at any time. All right, let's get back to KOSPA here. All right, the prices he was talking about earlier, them coincide absolutely with a five wave in here. Okay, if we go out to the 8 hour, it makes it a little bit easier to see here. Okay, I see exactly the target up here, 0.032. that's the trend based extension target. That would give us 1, 2, 3, 4. This fifth wave looks like it's starting now, and a fifth wave up. Now, nothing is guaranteed in this world, people, so please do not go put your life savings on here. I don't give financial advice. That's not for me. I'm not a financial advisor, okay? If you're tracking this, I think the best thing to really do, put a Fibonacci on this to make sure this fifth wave is coming in, okay? You can see we're pushing up through there. We're up through that 702 now, okay? We get through that 786. The big thing is we break that resistance at 0.0282. All right, then we have that fifth wave coming in. Okay, then it's going to push up them higher levels up here to that 0.0323. All right, I just want everybody to play it safe because anything can happen, okay? I thought an ABC was coming in yesterday. I honestly didn't see this wave one until I was really digging in this chart last night. I knew it could have been a wave one, but really wasn't sure. Okay, so if you went on the hourly, you can see it a little bit better here. A 1, 2, 3, 4. It's just your fourth wave is normally your biggest pullback, and then your fifth wave blow off, right? So be watching for that resistance at 0.0282. All right, we get through there, and we should be heading up to the 0.0323, okay? And then we should be doing an ABC correction up there, okay? That thing should be breaking down a little bit, pulling back. It'll probably pull back to this breakout of 0.0282 right here, all right, as long as we get up through there. All right, so I'm keeping an eye on this like I always do, guys. Absolutely. So thank you so much. Please hit the like and subscribe, and I'll talk to everybody soon. I hope everybody has a great night. Thanks a lot, guys. Appreciate your support. Thank you.